Hey everyone, going to quickly run through a simple but useful technique for converting a black and white image to black and transparent, or white and transparent, or even a color and transparent. There's a couple ways to do this, of course, but this is undoubtedly my favorite way. It goes like this. I've got a black and white layer. I'm going to double click on the layer to bring up the blending options. Then if I want to make the black transparent, I'll hold the Alt key in Windows or the Option key on a Mac and drag the black slider in the Blend If section for this layer all the way to the top. Or if I want to make the white transparent, I'll hold Alt or Option and drag the white slider all the way to the bottom. The important thing is holding Alt or Option. That splits this little slider up and makes it a smooth transition. I'm going to hit OK, and that gives us our transparency, but it does leave the color channels as they are, meaning we're still getting these gray values along the edges. To fill that all in with one color, I'm going to use Command or Control G to group this layer. That isolates this Blend If setting. Then I'm going to double click on the group folder to bring up its blending options and layer style effects. And I'm going to use the color overlay effect. Normal blending mode, 100% opacity, and that'll fill in any visible pixels with white or red or black or whatever you want to use. I'm going to hit OK. Then with the group still selected, Command or Control E to collapse that group into a single layer. So that took about a minute when I'm talking through it, but in real time and just to review, I've got a black and white layer. I'm going to go into Blend If and Alt drag the white slider down or the black slider up, group it, use color overlay on the group and select a fill color, then merge the group. What I like about this approach is partly that it's a few less steps than the standard method of copying your layer into a mask, but more importantly, copying a layer into a mask doesn't take into account things that might be off the edges of the artboard, and this technique does work with layers of any size. Hope this video will save you a little bit of time. Check out the channel for all kinds of longer form stuff and occasionally one of these little workflow tips. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.